हेलो फ्रेंड्स वनकम वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल शाइनी स्टार्स। सो இன்னைக்கு நம்ம சேனல்ல என்ன பார்க்க போறோம்னா அபௌட் ஸ்கிராப் புக் தான் பார்க்க போறோம். சோ வாங்க வீடியோக்குள்ள போலாம். ஸ்கிராப் புக்கிங் இஸ் a method of preserving, presenting and arranging personal and family history in the form of a book, box or card. Typical memorabilia include photographs, printed media and artworks. Scrapbook albums are often decorated and frequently contain extensive journal entries or written descriptions. Scrapbooking started in the United Kingdom in the 19th century. History. In the 15th century, commonplace books popular in England emerged as the way to compile information that included receipts, quotations, letters, poems and more. Each commonplace book was unique to its creator, particular interesters. Friendships albums become popular in the 16th century. These albums were used much like modern day yearbooks, where friends are patrons which would enter their names, titles and short extras or illustrations at the request of the album's owner. These albums were often printed as sovereigns of European tours and would contain local memorabilia including coats of arms or works of art commissioned by local artisans. Starting in 1570, it became fashionable to incorporate colored plates depicting popular scenes such as Venetian costumes or carnival scenes. This provided affordable options as compared to original works, and such as these plates were not sold to commemorate or document a specific event, but specifically as embellishment for albums. In 1735, James Granger published a history of England with several blank pages at the end of the book. The pages were designed to allow the book's owner to personalize the book with their own memorabilia. The practice of pasting engravings, lithographs and other illustrations into books, or even taking the book apart, inserting new matter and rebinding them, become known as extra illustrating or grammarizing. Additionally, friendship albums, confession albums and school yearbooks afforded girls in the 18th and 19th centuries an outlet through which to they share their literary skills and allowed girls an opportunity to document their own personalized historical record, previously not readily available to them. For example, college women around the turn of the century used scrapbooks extensively to construct representations of their everyday life as students. Without photograph albums to provide images of these life events, students created unique representations through scrapbooks in order to illustrate their lives using ephemera and memorabilia. A guest list or a group of visiting cards might represent a young woman's visit to a party. A playbill and ticket stub might serve as reminders of a trip to New York to see a Broadway show. Solid objects such as plants, silverware or small trinkets were used in when further visual representation was needed. A page from the subject-based scrapbooks might include class schedules, exam booklets, letters from professors or printed material from the school events. The scrapbooks from this era can create a more complete image of the Marquess life. During the 19th century, scrapbooking was seen as a more involved way to present one's experiences than journaling or other writing-based forms or logging. Printed materials such as cheap newspapers, visiting cards, playbills and pamphlets circulated by during the 19th century and often become the primary components of people's scrapbooks. The growing volume of ephemera of this kind, parallel to the growth of industrialized society, created a demand for methods of cataloging and preserving them. This is why scrapbooks developed solely to categorizing recipes, coupons or other lists were also common during this time. Until later in the 19th century, scrapbooks were seen as functional as well as aesthetically pleasing. Several factors including marketing strategies and technological advancement contributed to the image of scrapbooking moving further toward the aesthetic plane over the years. The advent of modern photography began with the first permanent photograph created by Joseph Nicephore Niesby in 1826. This allowed the average person to begin to incorporate photographs into their scrapbooks. However, books or albums made specifically for showcasing photographs alone were not popularized in the United States until closer to 1860. Before that point, photographs were not thought of as items to be reproduced and shared. Demand for photo albums was spurred on in large part by the growing popularity of the card TDVZ, a small photograph distributed in the same manner one might a visiting card. Old scrapbooks tended to have photos mounted with photo mounting corners and perhaps notations of who was on the photo or where and where it was taken. They often included bits of memorabilia like newspapers, clippings, letters, etc. An early known American scrapbooker and inventor of scrapbooking supplies was Mark Twain. Twain carried scrapbooks on his travels as his collectors, sovereigns, clippings and pictures. Friendship scrapbook examined from approximately 1795 to 1834. The following photographs show some of the pages from a memorial of friendship scrapbook kept by Annie Wagner, a British woman, between 1795 and 1834. She belonged to the same social circle as the poet Bessie Bysshe Shelley. Anna Wagner's scrapbook included pages she created as well as contributions from friends and relatives. The scrapbook contains handwritten poems, notes left by friends and relatives, and decoupage ephemeria like locks of hair, decorative paper clippings, ribbons, and detailed watercolor sketches. Marilyn Beardy Christine, pronounced as the name Marilyn of Elbridge, over the United States, formerly of Spanish book today, is credited with turning scrapbooking from what was once just the ages old hobby into the actual industry containing business devoted specifically to the manufacturing and the sale of scrapbooking supplies. She began designing creative pages for her family's photo memories, inserting the completed pages into sheet products collected in three-ring binders. By 1980, she had assembled over 50 volumes and was invited to display them at the World Conference on Records in Salt Lake City, 1981. Mary Lee and her husband Anthony J. AJ authored and published a how-to booklet, Keeping Memories Alive, and opened a scrapbook store in Spanish Fork that ended up with the same name that remains open today. In addition to preserving memories, the hobby is popular for the strong social network that scrapbooking can provide. Hobbyists, known as scrappers or scrapbookers, get together and scrapbook at each other's homes, local scrapbook stores, scrapbooking conventions, street trade centers, and even on cruisers. The term crop, a reference to cropping or trimming printed photographs, was smaller building next door and named the annex in its early years. Many of the stores have popped up and catered to the scrapbooking community. The shops provide many of the necessary tools for every scrapbooker's needs. Besides keeping memory alive, these include companies such as Creative Memories, Making Memories, Stampin' Up, and Close to My Heart. The scrapbooking industry doubled in size between 2001 and 2004 to 2.5 billion, with over 1,600 companies creating scrapbooking products by 2003. Creative Memories, a home-based retailer of scrapbooking supplies founded in 1987, saw $425 million in retail sales in 2004. Creative Memories' parent company did fire chapter level in 2013 and became the bankruptcy with the largest debt in the Twin City area. According to the Google Trends, the search terms related to scrapbook and scrapbooking have been a 70% decline since its peak is 2005 to 2006. However, there is much debate among the community of people who engage in memory keeping about what the decline means for the health and future of the industry as a whole. What seems to be clear is that traditional scrapbooking is once again in a transition period due to many forces, including current economic issues, the influence of social media and the ease of digital sharing, and the rejection of the stereotype of traditional scrapbooks being something that is for older men. However, if you want to take a closer look, it is easy to see all the ways people continue memory keeping even if it doesn't fall strictly within the definition of traditional scrapbooking as defined here. Some examples include the advent of smashbooks created by EK Success, which in some ways are a closer representation to original scrapbooks in that they are wire-bound books in a variety of sizes, consisting of blank printed background papers into which one can journal and glue mementos into it. Another variation is the introduction and growth of pocket scrapbooking, most well-known and represented by Project Life, created and introduced by Becky Higgins. Higgins created the system in response to her personal desire to continue to record the lives of her children and family, but in a quick way, more simple way that allowed her the flexibility to complete the project but still in an attractive, cohesive way. One of the newest trends in scrapbooking is bringing the layout designs down to such smaller size, small enough to carry in a small bag with on-the-go updates. An area for creativity and memory keeping. A traditional traveler's notebook is a simple leather cover with a band to keep close. The cover can hold up to 6 inches, which can be used in many ways. The notebook has grown in popularity, allowing for journaling and memory keeping for any interesters. Mini albums are another great way of memory keeping and a new trend in scrapbooking. They can be made in different sizes based on number of photos to be put inside the album. These mini albums can be constructed and handmade from research.